Vitoria, Spain. I came in with all these expectations about what it would be, based on my other experiences. Last year was Serbia, which can get pretty rowdy. And you already know what went down in Istanbul. But my first impression of the city was, it's calm. Must be silence before the storm, because I know it's going to get crazy when those games start. So much to see in a small city. But there were so many challenges waiting on me around the corner. Recently, four strangers, including me, met each other for the first time and we became a team. And after touring around Europe for a while, learning from pros and experiencing the culture together, this was our last stop, our 3-on-3 championship. And through it all, I had no idea if we were ready for it. But one thing that I did know is that we were more than excited to face new challenges. One of the biggest challenges is we don't have much time to prepare, but there's so much to work on. Defense, spacing, all of that. And what's worse is this is the last time I get to work with them.
So Valentin, what you're gonna need is patience first. Sometimes you try to speed up a little bit too fast, and we have guys, like two guys, that we have to use them to the best of their ability that can both shoot. All right, so now he's gonna dump him. He has an option. You have an option of going for a handoff right here, are throwing into the high post right here. Your job right away is establish position, like you're posting up. You cannot let this guy get around you. You understand that? You cannot let him get around you.
So we focused on what's easiest for them right now, and that's offense. These guys struggle with spacing a little. And in a 3-on-3, if you have good spacing, it's so hard to guard. That and a little something extra, but what I didn't want to do is interfere with the lessons that were going to be taught to us soon thereafter by someone who we all know. The Final Four was about to take place, but honestly, we were more concerned with learning as much as we could before it was time to play. There's a legend I was born in Spain. I've seen him hoop for so many years. Made big waves in Europe as a child. I think it's best to learn from someone like Rubio because he made it and doesn't pass the eye test. In Europe, you learn to play with your mind instead of your ability. It took for me to watch him live against Team USA before I realized how good he actually was. Now he does the exact same thing in the NBA. Ricky Rubio was in town, and out of all the things that he could have been doing, he was interacting with fans. He was a man really for the people, and I saw it with my own eyes. But there was no way we were going to let him go without finding a way to work out with him, pick his brain a little bit. I figured with his IQ, anything he says would be able to help us out.
I set him up, he goes under. It's illegal, but it's close to
illegal.
Depends how you do it. You know what I mean? So it's legal because he has to have the freedom to roll, but he has to have the freedom to go under too.
Yeah.
So if I'm going to do this, set the screen and you move, you gotta give him, the defender, the room to change angles. You know what I mean?
Okay.
So if I'm going like this and you change right away without giving me the room to really set the vantage,
okay, that's the rule.
You know what I mean? That's the rule. There's a lot of rules that are this close to be legal or illegal, you know what I mean? And the referee has like 0.2 seconds to really decide and get connected with the big. The connection between the big and the small are really important, because if you come and I go a second earlier, they're gonna call offensive foul on you. Next time I call you up for a pick and roll, you're gonna say like, I'm not gonna say it, but you know what I mean? Rudy got mad a lot with me in the beginning, and I got mad at him because he wasn't in the right spot. So it's something that you gotta be at the same time, and that's how you create chemistry with the big. for me and him with small. So you gotta know the strength of who you're playing against. Right. So if you play Steph Curry, there's no way you're going
under. No, you can't.
Not even half court. No. If you're playing against Russell Westbrook, he's better going to a rim than a three.
Right.
So you're playing, I'm not saying he's not gonna take the three and make it, he probably will, but if he goes to the rim and you go over, it's gonna be 10 out of 10 dunks.
Sure.
If you're going under and then trying, it's just not, one thing for sure is making him think what you're gonna do. You know what I mean? Like if you're going under all the time, he plays in NBA. Russell Westbrook plays in NBA. He's gonna make a three, you know what I mean? So he's gonna set up you and then, but if you go over, under, under, over, under, over, and he doesn't know where it comes from. You know, it happens to everybody. So in defense, it's about the strength. Mastering the pick and roll is one of the best things you can do to really play at the highest level.
So Ruby had a lot of good information. He shared some stuff with us that one thing I didn't even think about, but I thought it was good because I'm going to be sharing this stuff with kids all across the world. So I like that he's a guard that doesn't really depend on his athleticism. And he gave us a lot of tips that can help anybody, really, not just small guards, but athletic players, too. He's a guy that made a career in the NBA just by being skilled and smart. It was good to get a chance to just sit and just learn from him. You know, he shared a lot of experience that he had in the NBA. And, you know, what better source is there than to hear it from the source, you know, so... I'm happy that we got a chance to link up with them, and now we're headed to the game. Game's supposed to be good. Unfortunately, Fenerbahce has like a few hurt, injured players, but still should be fun to watch anyway. So we're gonna go enjoy it. The team we played against, they were just on the same page the whole time. It was impressive. They were moving the ball, hitting open shots, attacking the basket, locking up. Honestly, I had fun watching them. It takes a while to apply lessons learned in practice to the actual game. You speed up and go back to bad habits. It takes for you to gather yourself and calm down before you're able to implement everything. And I'm proud to say they did exactly that. Tresco, I love the motion that you play with. I've enjoyed watching you lead the team. And since we met, you developed more than I expected. Valentin, you got injured but traveled with the team and always paid attention to everything. You even simplified your game to make sure you were more efficient. Stelios, every stop we made, you've improved big time. Your ones got a lot better and moving without the ball. And sometimes, you're almost impossible to guard. This was for sure a humbling experience for me. And as always, getting to make friends on the other side of the globe. And I'm positive that everyone will come back a little bit smarter. And a lot better on the next trip. Coming out here always brings life back into basketball, in my mind. And even in Final Four, where the atmosphere is out of this world. To see all these guys compete and work hard for the love of the game. I've been here for the last 3 years. I've seen Fenerbahce at the top of the mountain, and then I've seen them fall short. But the fans are always with them. I've seen Luka become a legend in both EuroLeague and in NBA. And this year I saw a new champion arise. But either way, the feeling is always there. And my only hope is that more people get a chance to experience it.
Lies within each of us. It's like the work of a wild animal.